silent movies have always been really, really important to me, especially Buster Keaton was always a touchstone for me. A lot of the films of Jean Renoir, especially Rules of the Game, has always been a big favorite. But then there's also, a lot of American classics like Coppola's film, The Conversation. It's a remarkable movie. Midnight Run.
Yes.
I think there are certainly echoes of Midnight Run in Better Call Saul. Yeah. All that jazz in the movie that gets mentioned really early. Network is a great movie. Personal favorite of mine is a movie called The In-Laws with Peter Falk. And then there's another movie that really speaks to me as a filmmaker. It's a movie called Topsy Turvy.
So I want to know, which are the shows whose titles that you like?
The ones that I think about are the original TV show Mission Impossible, A Fuse, going across the screen. That one is just, to me, very eye-catching. There's a British show called The Prisoner. It's a show about a spy. He's almost a James Bond type. And the opening titles tell the whole story of him resigning and getting kidnapped and being unable to escape, all encapsulated in probably 60 seconds. There's a show here called Fargo. One of the things that Fargo does is very interesting. There's actually almost no main title at all, and all the titles go to the back of the show.
That's interesting. So I wanted to know, which are the monologues that have inspired you throughout your life that have stayed with you in a way?
There's one in Breaking Bad. Mike tells a story to Walt. He uses the phrase,
"No more half measures, Walter."
One that always stays with me is a movie called The Verdict. There's a tremendous monologue at the end of it. It's actually a summation to a jury. If you've ever seen the movie There Will Be Blood,
yeah,
anything in that movie is they're all great monologues.
I would like to know, as a writer, do you prefer reading fiction or nonfiction?
I like them both. Sometimes it's easier to read nonfiction. The French author Emile Zola, I just finished one the other day, La Bête Humaine, The Human Beast. I thought it was really spectacular. Well, you know, Catch 22, which is a book by Joseph Heller. It's a very funny book. I also love anything by Kurt Vonnegut, Charles Dickens. You know, I read Bleak House. There's a historian named Anthony Beevor, and he wrote a book about Stalingrad that I love. And also George Orwell. And I just read Homage to Catalina, and then Down and Out in Paris and London. I mean, they're both rip-roaring reads. Really, really enjoyable. And then, of course, anything by Stephen King. Nonfiction-wise, a book called Nixonland by Rick Perlstein. It's all about America in the really the 60s and 70s.
Are you a podcast fan in general?
Yeah, I love podcasts. I love the BBC History Extra podcast. And there's also a BBC show called In These Times. There's a podcast called 99% Invisible, which is a podcast which is about design, the design of the world that I really enjoy. There's an artificial intelligence podcast that's hosted by an academic thing, Lex Friedman, Lex Friedman podcast. That's also sometimes very, very interesting. Roger Deakins just came out with a podcast. I've only listened to a little bit of it, but I think that's very exciting. That there's a venue for to hear what Roger Deakins and his friends think about filmmaking.
Absolutely.
Please watch Charge Talks and subscribe right below on YouTube.